You know we love our sweets here.
We do.
We do a lot of stuff with chocolate, but this truthfully is one of the best ones that we've ever done. It is a brand new take on an old classic in Beverly Hills, andSons chocolate. Take a look.
Here, downtown LA at the andSons Chocolatier's factory. Now they have a store in Beverly Hills, but this is where it all goes down. Start with how this all came about, because I know your mom dabbled in chocolate.
She opened the store in 1983. We've been around for 36 years. My brother and I, Mark, took it over about 6 years ago. And we now make a full line of confections, both modern style and classics.
We have them molded with the colors, and that really is expressive, especially to the Beverly Hills crowd and the LA crowd. But we do have a classic line as well, which is always the color of the chocolate, whether it be milk chocolate or black chocolate.
And you said confections, because it's not only chocolate. You guys do more than that too.
So we specialize in confections, which are really unique pieces going past bars, but to combine a lot of different ingredients to make ganaches, pralines, chandouillas, caramels, which really elevates the product and, you know, requires a pretty amount of like sense of skill to do that type of stuff.
Everything is so beautiful, but when it comes to making the actual chocolate, do you guys collaborate on flavors, or how does this all come together?
At times we do. You know, we have an idea of what we want. You know, it all kind of culmination of my 30 years experience and their life in the business as well. You know, I think the most popular one that we have in the line is the lemon verbena and yuzu. There's two ganaches in there. This is passion fruit and caramel. This is praline, hazelnut, and pop rock. I took the colors off the packaging to match the color of the bonbon. Now, nobody ever picks up on that, but I grew up eating that sort of stuff when I was a kid. And we're buying these actually unflavored, so they're not the cherry berry flavored or whatever they are. They're really, really expensive to get them that way, but we really think it's worth it because the explosion in your mouth when you start biting into it is really incredible.
There they go.
Yeah, it takes a second.
And these are so fun to eat.
But it instantly just starts crackling. Cool. But then it just starts dancing.
Mm-hmm. So in this case, we have some enrobed bonbons. This one is a apricot patafouille with an almond marzipan and saffron ganache. This is gianduja. It's a hazelnut milk and white chocolate. And this is a unique chocolate that we got out of Bali, Indonesia. And it's a very limited run from our partner, Belrona in France. And they found this plantation in Bali that grows a very small amount of cacao.
So you took over after Mama's legacy. Yeah. What does it mean to your family that it's still in the family to be making this chocolate?
She approves.
That's the most important.
Which is the most important thing, exactly. People always ask, what does she think? She's totally on board. And you know, yeah, she built a wonderful community in Beverly Hills of regulars that have been coming for many years. We have a cafe also that's part of our community. And so it was really kind of looking at it and seeing what was working, what was sort of in need for an update, and coming up with those ideas and executing those things. So, I mean, for her, it was like something she wanted to do, but obviously she'd been doing it long enough, and it was now our turn.
35 years in food, that's like 180 years in reality.
It's like dog years.
Basically, yeah. You know, for me, it's not about being super innovative, it's just about being good. And this is chocolate. People already want to eat it, so there's no reason to put cilantro in it or something that doesn't go with chocolate or make it difficult.
Or anything.
Make it difficult for them to eat it. So it's just important to make stuff that people want.
It is so good. And andSons, the actual shop that you see there, is located on Brighton Way in Beverly Hills. And something I didn't know until I was working on the piece, and I really just wanted to mention, is that so the chocolatier, as they say in that little short piece, is named Chris. Chocolatier? Chocolatier. Chorizo. His name is Chris Harvey. And he is kind of like an Instagram pastry chef. I didn't know this. this is just like more and more of this food porn that he does, and it's just so delicious. Very, very thankful we got to do that. It was great stuff. We'll be back with more Five Live right after this.